Decided to get into trials? Great! All you need to do now is decide which sort of trials bike to buy. Trials is mostly about rider skill and not the bike you are riding. So don't stress too much about making exactly the right choice. Here are some rough guidelines. Are you into the old school? Your club may have a classic class for vintage bikes built before 1965. Next, there's often a twin shock class for trials bikes. These are usually built before 1985 and they have two rear shocks for the rear suspension. Then there are the monoshock trials bikes, usually built from 1985 and on. These have become lighter and more capable every year. As a rough rule of thumb, if you plan on learning very quickly and moving up through the grades, aim for a trials model manufactured from 2000 and on. What size will suit you? There's a wide range from 50cc trials bikes for kids to over 300cc in two-stroke or four-stroke for adults. If you can get a ride on various bikes, you will quickly get a feel for what suits you best. For adults, many believe that 200cc is the ideal for beginners, as the reduced power is less likely to cause issues as you learn your basic skills, and it's still a bike that can take you into the higher grades. However, it is common for adults to start on a 125. They have such a mellow throttle response down low and encourage much needed clutch skills. Experienced motorbike riders, but who are new to trials, sometimes buy the 250 to 300cc bikes as they plan on learning fast. Initially, it does make it harder to master the basic skills due to that stronger engine response, but there are ways to mellow the response of a bigger engine while you are learning. Most modern bikes have a mapping switch which will have a softer setting. You can buy throttle tubes with a slower twist to take away any snappiness at low revs, and some riders even put an extra washer or two on the spark plug to lower the compression. Four-stroke or two-stroke? Some riders prefer four strokes. The pros and cons are similar when looking at dirt bikes. In a nutshell, the advantages of a four-stroke are a tamer engine response, usually quieter if practicing in the backyard, more engine braking, fewer engine rebuilds, no messing around with two-stroke oil, and better fuel economy. If you also plan on some trail riding, then four strokes are generally smoother and quieter on open trails at a consistent speed. Yeah. Drawbacks with the four strokes? More expensive, slightly heavier, and the engine rebuild will be more expensive and time consuming, although it usually takes ages to wear any trials engine out. Most of the world's top trials riders choose two strokes, but if you look at any vids of Tony Bow doing insane tricks on his four-stroke, you will see it's the rider, not the type of bike, that really makes the difference. Electric trials bikes are an interesting development. Brands like Osset have bikes for kids with a decent battery life and the added advantage of being able to ride in the backyard without annoying the neighbours. Improved battery life, weight, and the addition of clutches have the electric bikes approaching the abilities of their petrol-driven cousins. It's a rapidly growing area. Google around to see what's available. Which brand is best? If you are looking at a modern trials bike, really, for beginners, there is very little difference between the major brands. Most have been around a long time, and all the bikes are very refined, high-quality beasts. The vast majority of us will never get close to testing the limits of what these bikes can do, so we usually don't recommend one brand over another. Look for reviews from experienced test riders when choosing, along with how easily you'll be able to access parts and servicing in your area. Also, you can join a trials club before you buy a bike. Club members often are very happy to give you a rundown on various brands, might even let you try their bike, and help you source a bike to buy. Remember guys, we've got heaps of training vids on our YouTube trials channel. Get into it.